Welcome back. This is round two. I get to be on the play. And an excellent hand. This time I'm going to lead with a mountain just in case I somehow need to lightning axe plus fiery temper on turn two. If my opponent goes turn one crypt breaker, turn two wharf infiltrator, then maybe I'll need to make that play. My opponent mulligan to five and scry to the top. Blue red, one of my favorite archetypes, and blue and red both seem to be relatively open at the table, so I could certainly see this player having a good deck. I think that just the card quality was pretty high in this draft, and my first round opponent's deck was quite good, and my deck's quite good. All right. So I can either fiery temper that, getting two damage, or I can just ignore it, attack post combat transform, or attack post combat alchemist greeting. I think of those options. Oh, or I could cast Veldarin Pariah. That actually seems like the best option. Attack, these guys will bounce, and then I'll play my Pariah. Pariah and Noosecraft Mob is a pretty sweet combo. Yeah, definitely taking that damage. Maybe my opponent just figures he or she's not going to be able to profitably block either creature next turn, so might as well attack. It's the Frost Breath thing. Just tap one of my guys. Okay. Sure. And then I think I'm just going to pass with mana open. Remember, I can kill two creatures at instant speed if I need to. Or I can just transform Conduit of Storms. Drag under targeting Conduit of Storms. Sure. No blocks, do you have any effects? And then I'm going to use Lightning Axe with the more expensive Alchemist's Greeting here. Keep the Fiery Temper in my hand. Rush of Adrenaline would be nice here, but my opponent should definitely let me target with Alchemist's Greeting. Yeah, this is a slight Magic Online error made by my opponent here. So he's making a 6/6 Ingenious Scab, but I actually haven't even cast Alchemist's Greeting now, so now I can just target the Scab with both spells. Whereas if my opponent had let me cast the Greeting, I would have targeted the Nevelgast Herald. Or maybe my opponent tricked me. Maybe that's what he or she wanted me to do. And for every creature my opponent plays, I'm going to get a 2/2 zombie, and then once we each have three, I could just transform this. It's a pretty tough spot for my opponent to be in. Wretched Griff, sure. And perhaps I should have used Fiery Temper instead of Alchemist's Greeting, if I had thought more about a card like Wretched Griff. Well, looks like I can attack with Noosgraf Mob. I get moderately blown out by an instant because then the mob would get pumped down to 3/3. But I could cast Fiery Temper to trade with the Griff, or I could activate Fuldaran Pariah's ability. All things considered, I'm going to attack with the mob. I'm likely to get in 4 damage, and the downside, I have some ways to mitigate the damage if my opponent does have a trick. Block and have an instant. Galvanic Bombardment targeting the other zombie. So maybe that makes this a good time to activate the Pariah. So I could either sacrifice 3 guys. Then it's just 6/5 Pariah against nothing. Or I could let my zombie die and Fiery Temper this, get another zombie, and then it's going to be Pariah and 2 zombies against nothing. Yeah, that's better. And I could actually transform the Pariah now and then have it be 6/5 and 2/2 Noosgraf Mob. But of course, if I was going to do that, I should have targeted my opponent with Fiery Temper. I think I'm fine with this. Just let them trade. I should have played my land last turn. That was a substantial mistake because now I can't transform the conduit right away. I will say my opponent made a game of this after Mulligan to 5 and me having an excellent hand. Multiple rares. Alright. So I'll probably be transforming my Pariah. That actually changes things. So option A, transform Pariah, attack for 6. Then if my opponent just has a removal spell, like say a reduce to ashes, I could actually lose the game from that position. Option B, cast certain death on assembled alphas. Put my opponent to 9, attack with everything. Or cast certain death on assembled alphas, attack with just Voldaren Pariah. Put my opponent to 6. Surely that's the best. And you see how badly I was punished by not playing my land 2 turns ago and not being able to transform the conduit because then I drew a spell, obviously, that I needed to cast. And I might have just made the same mistake again. No, never mind, I'm 1 mana short if I was to draw another land. So 0 cards for my opponent. Can transform the conduit, attack with conduit, post-combat play Voldaren Pariah. Or I could just play Pariah Brazen Wolves. Or I could play Pariah Brazen Wolves, transform Pariah, attack with conduit. And then my opponent will have to answer both creatures or be dead next turn. I like that the best. So sacrifice 3 creatures, please. And swing. Alright, so against a blue-red spells-ish deck, with some bounce, some combat tricks. Unclear if I really need to change anything. I could cut a land, like a land and an expensive spell, but I kind of like all my expensive spells in this matchup. Yeah, I'm just gonna stick with it. Another great hand. Nice. Right on time. Sure. Whenever I play against these blue-red decks, I always just hope that they tap their mana on their main phase so that it's easier to know what to do. Given that I now have an instant speed removal spell, it doesn't seem that bad to just attack with both my creatures. Sure. And post-combat transform. Otherwise, my mana is going to go to waste. I feel like this is going to get bounced or killed or something, but might as well spend my mana. It's funny. I did not predict that inner struggle. So now my hand's just all removal. And my opponent wisely plays a creature that's so bad that I refuse to spend removal on it. Huh. Deny existence. Okay. Sure. The scab is something that I'm willing to spend removal on. But now, should I just cast my innkeeper first, maybe? And if my opponent attacks with a scab, I'm going to take the damage. I don't want to trade. Sure. So now maybe I'll do the Lightning Axe plus Alchemist's Greeting. I'm going down to 12. Question is, do I want to be trading three damage for two damage against my opponent? Probably yes. All right, so I can play three things now. Lightning Axe here. Alchemist's Greeting the flyer. Play the Dragoon. Suppose I might as well trade with the Falconwrath Reaver. And then I just have a 3-3 against nothing and certain death for my opponent's next big threat. Pretty good spot. And I like being able to pare down resources when I play against the blue-red decks because you know you're not going to die to some kind of combo finish with Mercurial Geists and Uncaged Fury or something like that. The fewer cards in my opponent's hand, the better. Okay, fair enough. Who can stick the first creature? That's getting certain death. That's getting throttled. Oh no, please tell me. Okay. If that was a rush of adrenaline, it was going to get pretty bad for me. Wretched Griff, and suddenly we got a game. My opponent must have had a series of pretty nice draws there, although I should not be complaining about my own draws. Seven mana with an eighth in my hand is a fine spot to be in case I draw Midnight Scavengers, which would be a fantastic draw at this stage in the game, by the way. There we go. Ask and ye shall receive. Return Conduit of Storms. If I had played one extra land, I could play around Convolute, which, if my opponent's playing Deny Existence, could easily be playing Convolute as well. Four. Fortune's Favor. How about a reduced to ashes face up and three face down cards? My opponent took the three lands. Gone missing, okay. Crack the clue, play a land. And I'm just gonna main phase transform, play around some kind of fiery temper type damage-based removal. Although, as we learned, this does not play around Inner Struggle, the main phase transform. I know my opponent has at least two lands in hand. Stands to reason it could be more. Could be combat tricks. Though he or she did not have rush of adrenaline a few turns ago, and yeah, all right, so I'm on to the finals. My opponent had a bad hand, decided to concede, or had no answer to the creatures on the table, I guess.